In this episode of Intuo Focus, we will be going over the macros panel and the many ways it can be useful for your music creating process. Macros offer a simple way to control multiple parameters with a single knob. It's especially useful for modifying a sound during a live performance. Instruments available in the Sound Store usually have several macros pre-configured, or you can pre-configure macros of your own. You can learn useful parameter combinations by exploring and experimenting with them. On the left, go to the Macros tab. There are up to 16 macro controls available. You can switch between the display of macro knobs by pressing their corresponding button. Macros can also be displayed as an XY touch controller for more convenient performance use. They are arranged into pairs. The horizontal axis controls one macro, and the vertical axis controls another. At the bottom, press the corresponding button to change the display. Most parameters available within BeatMaker 3 can be assigned to a macro knob, such as editor, sampler and modulation parameters, mixer controls, any effect parameter, and also plugin parameters by using the Show AU Knobs mode from the plugin view. When assigning a parameter to a macro, simply double tap the desired parameter. For this example, I will select the tune parameter. A submenu will pop up. Go to Macro Controls and select the macro you wish to assign it to, which I'll select Macro 1. When we go back to the Macros panel, we can now see the tune parameter assigned to Macro 1. You can repeat the same process for any number of parameters and also assign them to one or several macro controls. Each macro has an editor panel, which can be entered by tapping the three dots next to the macro knob. This panel contains a list of all assigned parameters for this particular macro. You can see the tune parameter that I assigned. The three dots on the top right corner will enable you to rename the macro, move or assign it to a different number, change the color using the color palette, or to delete it. The three dots on the bottom right corner will enable you to delete a particular parameter, that is if you assigned more than one parameter to a single macro. You are also able to swap the minimum and maximum values. The minimum and maximum values allow you to configure the control range by adjusting the parameters to the desired position. For this example, I've set the minimum to negative 12 and the maximum to positive 12. Now when I play around with the tune macro, I can adjust it to go down or up an octave. The macro control value can also be locked by tapping on the lock icon. Releasing the macro will reset to the locked value. Here's an example of some custom macros that can be utilized during a live performance. As you can see, you have a lot of different options to customize your macros and get really creative. It can enhance your music creation process for both in the studio and especially for live performances. So don't be afraid to try it out, experiment, and just have fun with it. Before we wrap this up, I'm going to take it a step further and assign a few of the macros to the knobs on my MIDI controller. Hope you found this helpful. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next one. The top of 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 the top of